All right, I've simplified the definition of the point class. I removed the properties. So we have a simple constructor and the draw method. And we're using this point class below its definition. Now, this is a very simple program with only one file, but the real world application consists of tens or hundreds of files. We don't want to write all the code in one file like main.ts. So ideally, I want to move the definition of this point class somewhere else in a file like point.ts. So here in this project, I'm going to add a new file, point.ts. Now back in main.ts, I'm going to select all this code, cut it, and move it to point.ts. Now, in TypeScript, we have this concept called modules. Now, what a module is requires a little bit more explanation, but for now, let me give you a simple, pragmatic definition. In TypeScript, you can think of each file as a module. So in this program, we can say we have two modules, but this is not quite accurate because these files are not modules yet. So in point.ts, we have defined this class called point, but this is not accessible anywhere outside this file. So this file defines its own scope. In order for us to use this class somewhere else in our program, we need to export this to the outside. So we add the export keyword here, and now this is visible outside this file. Now that we're exporting something on top of this file, from TypeScript's point of view, this file is a module. Now we need to go back to our main.ts and import this class so we can use it. So back in main.ts, look, we have a compilation error. Cannot find name point because we have not imported this into main.ts. So on the top, we write import. In curly braces, we add the name of the types we want to import. In this case, point. Now, if there are multiple types we want to import, we separate them using comma, okay? So we import point from, now here we put the name of the module in quotes. What is the name of the module? It's the relative path to that module from this file. So both these files are in the same folder. We can use period slash, which refers to the current folder. And then point is the name of our module. So it's not point.ts. Look, we get a compilation error. So the name of our module is point. Now we no longer have a compilation error here, and we can create an instance of this point class and use it. Now there is a lot more to talk about when it comes to modularity in TypeScript, but that's all you need to know for now in order to start building applications with Angular. Because in Angular framework, we have a lot of types that are exported, so we need to import these into our TypeScript files and use them. You're going to see that a lot in this course. The only difference is that Angular modules are defined in a different way, so we don't add the relative paths to these module files, because these files are not really part of our application. They're somewhere inside node underline modules folder. So when it comes to importing types defined in Angular, we use the library name as the module name. For example, one of the libraries is at Angular slash core. Okay, so here's the lesson. In TypeScript, we divide our program into multiple files. In each file, we export one or more types. These types can be classes, functions, simple variables, or objects. And wherever we need to use these types, we need to import them first. When we have an import or export statement on top of a file, that file is a module from TypeScript's point of view. In Angular, we also have the concept of modules, but Angular modules are a little bit different. They're not about organization of code in different files. They are about organization of your application into smaller functional areas. You're going to learn about Angular modules in the next section.